Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. ThinkCell's Gantt chart cannot only be controlled by its calendar, but also by Excel, either through the chart's internal datasheet or through any linked Excel sheet. Let's take a look at this Gantt chart and use dates from its datasheet to control its items. Click on the Open Datasheet button in the bottom right corner of the chart. Each row in the datasheet corresponds to an activity row in the Gantt chart. Enter the description for the first activity into column A of the second row. This will be displayed in the activity column of the chart. Type the date for the beginning of the first task into column B. Enter the end date of the task into column C, and the date for the milestone into column D. Of course, the actual meaning of the columns is up to you, and you can add further dates to the row if needed. Once you have entered a date into the datasheet, an anchor point is added to the Gantt chart at the top of the row for that date. A green line at the beginning of the row indicates that this row is now linked to the datasheet. Cells that do not contain data in an Excel date format will not create anchor points in the Gantt chart. This allows you to use cells as input for formulas, for example, task durations for calculating the end date from the start date of a task. After entering the dates into the datasheet and thus creating anchor points in the Gantt, you can now anchor timeline items to them. Drag the handle at the beginning of the bar to the first anchor point. Now drag the handle at the end of the bar to the second anchor point. Finally, anchor the milestone to the third anchor point. From now on, these items will be updated automatically if you change the dates in the datasheet. When inserting more dates, we recommend sticking to the input pattern you used for the initial row. For example, keep using columns B and C for the start and end date of an activity bar in all rows, and column D for a milestone. In other words, a specific column should be used consistently for the same type of item throughout the whole datasheet. As you add dates to new rows in the datasheet, new items are automatically added to the Gantt chart. The new items are modeled on the items in the existing row above. This also means that the new items are automatically anchored to the respective anchor points of the new row. That way, you do not have to manually insert and anchor the items for all activity rows, but can create a complete Gantt chart directly from the datasheet using the structure defined in the initial row. To link milestones in the special row below the Gantt chart to the datasheet, type their dates into the first row of the datasheet, and anchor the milestones to the anchor points. If you work from an existing data range, do the following to quickly fill the Gantt chart without manually anchoring each item. Start with the initial row. Insert items as needed and attach them to the anchor points. Then, select all items you added to the initial row, hold down the Shift and Control keys, and drag the selection to the next row. The items are duplicated and anchored to the corresponding anchor points in the next data row. The Shift-Control-Drag shortcut is the same used for PowerPoint shapes, where Control-Dragging duplicates shapes and holding down Shift additionally aligns them appropriately. As with any data-driven chart, you can of course also use an external Excel file instead of the internal datasheet to drive the Gantt chart. For general information on how to work with Excel files as a data source for ThinkCell charts, please watch our video on Excel data links. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.